Suffering for years, Kratos, the once great general, now known as the Ghost of Sparta, had pledged himself as a champion to the gods of Olympus. In return, he hoped only to rid himself of the nightmares that haunted him for far too long. But for now, his only respite, his only relief from the sins of his past, was found in the heat of battle. And on this day, Kratos had been called upon by the gods to confront an unthinkable evil, unleashed on the city of Attica by the invading Persian army.
Yeah! What evil have you wrought on this city, Persian?
Evil? It is not evil that I bring, Spartan. I bring the might of Persia and the sacrament of purification. As we speak, my basilisk cleanses this land so that it may embrace the glory of the Persian Empire.
Olympus has sent a message, and I am here to deliver it.
Then you are just a messenger. So take this message back to your little gods. It will take more than a pathetic Spartan to stop the power of the Empire. Spare my life, and I will give you all that you ask.
You have nothing I want, Persian.
Take my kingdom, my women, my gold.
I won't take your riches, but I will take your life.
Ah!
Fulfilling his commitment to the gods, Kratos defeated the basilisk brought forth by the Persians. But this small victory would not satisfy the man who had come to be known as the Ghost of Sparta.
Is this all you would have me do? Is there nothing else?
Plummet through the sky and the world plunge into darkness, Kratos knew this was not a sign from the gods.
What treachery is this?
Setting his sights on the glowing horizon, Kratos made his way toward the mysterious light. But there was more afoot than Kratos could possibly know. In the darkness, Morpheus, the god of dreams, awakened to a world where he and only he wielded power. The land was slowly overrun by a black fog that engulfed everything it touched. Morpheus affected even Kratos as he was haunted by a strange melody. And as Kratos approached the temple, it became clear that the task ahead was more than he could have ever imagined. Once again, the strange, lingering melody could be heard through the black fog of Morpheus, haunting Kratos. Kratos stood was the sun chariot of Helios, the very chariot that the fire steeds pulled across the sky every day, allowing the brilliance of Helios to shine down on all mankind.
Kratos.
Athena! What madness has befallen us?
Kratos, there is not much time. Olympus needs you.
I grow tired of the gods' request, Athena. I have given enough. Now take these nightmares from my head!
It is not for you to say when your servitude ends. You will earn your freedom in time. But for now, Olympus needs your unquestioning obedience. The god of the sun has been torn from the sky. This temple on which you stand is the chariot of Helios. Without their master to reign them, the fire steeds have driven the sun chariot into the earth. And without Helios, there is no one to keep Morpheus from seizing permanent power. Many of the gods have fallen into a deep slumber. Soon, all will succumb to the black grip of Morpheus.
What would you have me do?
You must find Helios and return him to the sky. Lest the world of gods and man be lost forever. Only his light can release the grasp of Morpheus.
Athena! Athena!